experiment. We don't do the with the time to spend. They book a musical minds and only ship.
Thank you very much. Is this working? It's working now. Okay. We're extremely happy to be here. The eclectic band can be made up of just about anything. And in recent years, it has been made up of just about anything that you could think of that would get together, and I'm very fortunate. I know a lot of very, very talented arrangers and writers, David Rishpan, Chris Smith, Alex Cote. There's lots and lots of people who write for this band. Our approach this semester was going back into their tradition. The music that we're playing tonight was played on a concert in 1990 featuring Miles with the Quincy Jones Orchestra at Montreux. The arrangements themselves have been obviously modified a bit because of the orchestration, but as far as I'm concerned, and as far as anybody I know who's involved in jazz music, this is like biblical stuff that we're playing. And I think that the band, considering the fact that they don't have, when the year started, they didn't have a lot of connection to it, but I think they're doing a great job, and maybe you could show them a little bit of love because of, yeah. Thank you very much. We're gonna continue. A beautiful tune that I first heard from Bill Evans, the monster piano player, a beautiful ballad called My Ship.
Thank you.
We're going to continue with an ornamentation from the beatnik area of our history. And I don't know if you notice this, but a lot of words were ended with ville. Like, we're in Schoolville. Or, that was very, very Coolville. And here is a tune called Springville. John Carisi wrote it, by the way, and this is an arrangement of Gil Evans, adapted by David Richman. Chris Smith, you can't confuse them, sorry.
It everybody, it's spring, it really is, it really is, it really is. And all the creatures prepare for shore. So the little one, I know you'll come home. Loveliest time of the year. From the sea, thank you.
Thank you. We'd like to remind you all that this is a big week of concerts for the jazz department, or for the jazz section in the music department. And as always, and I always say the same thing, but I guess when you've done as many gigs as I have, or my brothers and sisters who teach here, or even some of the students who obviously they play gigs because that's what they're going to do, we always need your support, always, always, always. And any time that you can tell a friend or two to come with you, because there's something good happening at the Loyola Concert Hall. And I must also make a little remark that this is a pretty nice place to hear any kind of music. But jazz is really, we're very fortunate to have this space. So we are going to continue with, hold on. So here's a tune you never heard ever, okay? Followed by a tune that actually gives the direction of where we're going after we finish the tune that you never ever heard before. So, but before we do that, I want to thank everybody at the hall, everybody who puts their 2 cents worth of skill into making this seem so relaxed and so easy and so comfortable. And I say this at every concert, but it's true. We need your support. We need people to come to bolster not only me when I play, or Charles, or Baron, or Robin, or anybody, but anybody that plays music, this whole gang here, they also go and they play music in clubs for 11 people. They know what it's like. And yet, something drives them to continue and to go forward. I won't be talking to you again, I promise. Thank you for your presence and thank you for your energy.
Summertime and everything is easy. Fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Oh, your daddy's rich and your mom is good looking. So hush, little baby, don't you cry. Then you're gonna scratch your wings. You'll take a
Just want to point out that Paimon wrote the shout chorus of that last song. Yes.
Thank you.
we're going to finish with a tune that really expresses where we're going. Look in your program. Do you have a program? Okay.